Roulette looks fair. 18 red pockets, 18 black pockets, a perfect 50-50 game. But former casino insiders reveal the wheel is built to trick you. The green zero, hiding in plain sight, shatters any chance at true fairness, quietly turning every bet into a mathematical loss. Nearly every player misreads their odds, and by the time you notice, your chips are gone. The secret? It is not luck, it is probability, designed to empty your wallet one spin at a time. How deep does the deception go? A roulette wheel draws people in with its perfect symmetry. 18 red pockets, 18 black. The alternating colors, the clean layout, the sense of balance. Everything about the design whispers fairness. Players scan the felt and see what looks like a pure coin flip, a 50-50 chance every time the ball drops. Dealers say that illusion is the first thing new staff are taught to see through. One former croupier remembers the lesson, count the pockets. There are always more than you think. On a European wheel, there are 37 slots, 18 red, 18 black, and a single green zero. On the American version, there are 38 slots, the same red and black, but two greens, zero, and double zero. That is not a minor detail. The symmetry is broken quietly by those green pockets. They are not just decoration. They are the casino's silent advantage. The colors draw your eye, but the numbers tell the real story. When you bet on red or black, you are not betting on 18 out of 36. You are betting on 18 out of 37 or 18 out of 38. The odds shift almost invisibly, just enough to guarantee that over time, the house always stays ahead. The surface glamour, the spinning wheel, the crisp chips, the alternating colors, masks a deeper math that most players never stop to count. That is by design. The wheel looks fair, but its beauty is only skin deep. A bet on red or black feels like the simplest wager in the room, but the numbers underneath tell a different story. On a European roulette wheel, with its 37 pockets, betting on red gives you 18 chances to win out of 37. That is a win probability of 48.65%. On an American wheel, the odds drop even further, 18 out of 38, or 47.37%. The green pockets, zero or zero and double zero, are the reason. They do not just break the color symmetry, they quietly push every even money bet below a true coin flip. Dealers are taught to see this gap immediately. When a player puts chips on red, the math is already against them before the ball spins. Out of 37 or 38 possible outcomes, only 18 pay out. The rest, whether it is black or green, mean a loss. That means over hundreds of spins. The expected result is always negative for the player. For every $100 wagered on red at a European table, the long-term expectation is a loss of $2.70. On an American wheel, the expected loss is $5.26 per $100 bet. The difference may look small, but it compounds relentlessly. Even on bets that feel almost even, the house edge is baked in by the extra pocket. The more spins a player makes, the more that edge eats away at their bankroll. The wheel's design ensures that the numbers always add up in the casino's favor, no matter how fair the game appears on the surface. A straight-up bet on a single number, what gamblers call the long shot, is the purest wager on the roulette table. You pick one number out of all the pockets, hoping the ball lands exactly where you want it. The payout for this bet is 35 to 1. That means if you put down $1 and your number hits, you get $35 in winnings, plus your original dollar back. It feels generous, almost thrilling, to see that stack of chips pushed your way. But the odds behind the payout tell a different story. On a European wheel, there are 37 numbers. On American tables, there are 38. The true odds of hitting your chosen number are 1 in 37 or 1 in 38. If the game were perfectly fair, if the payout matched the risk, the casino would pay you 36 to 1 or 37 to 1. But they do not. they always pay 35 to 1, no matter how many pockets the wheel has. That gap is the invisible cut the casino takes from every bet, every spin, every hopeful chip placed on a single number. A former floor manager explains it this way. Players see the big payout and think they are getting a square deal. But the house always pays out less than the true odds. That is the whole business. Over time, this difference adds up. For every $37 you bet on a European wheel, you expect to win once and lose 36 times. Your total payout is $36, $1 less than you started with. That missing dollar is the house edge, built right into the payout table. On American wheels, it is even sharper. You lose $2 for every $38 wagered. This shortfall is not just for straight bets. It is the foundation for every wager on the table. The math is always tilted, quietly, in favor of the house. The straight-up bet just makes the mismatch crystal clear. The roulette layout is full of bets that look clever, but one stands out for all the wrong reasons. On American wheels, there is a five-number wager known as the basket bet. It covers 0, 00, 1, 2, and 3, five numbers in a neat cluster at the top of the felt. The payout flashes 6 to 1, tempting players who think they are stacking the odds in their favor by covering more numbers. But the math behind this bet is brutal. The probability of winning the basket is 5 out of 38. That is just over 13%. But the payout is set as if you are beating much longer odds. For every $100 you risk on this bet, the expected loss is almost $8, specifically $7.89. That is a 7.89% house edge, the highest of any wager on the American roulette table. By comparison, most other bets on the same wheel cost you about $5.26 for every $100. The basket quietly drains your bankroll 50% faster than any other standard bet. Dealers see the damage up close. One recalls a regular who insisted on playing the basket every spin, convinced that covering the top was a secret advantage. Over the course of an hour, the player lost hundreds, even as the ball landed on his numbers a few times. The small wins never caught up to the steady, invisible drain. Chips disappeared faster than anywhere else on the table. The illusion is safety in numbers, but in reality, the basket bet is a trap. More coverage does not mean better odds. It just means you are betting more money into the worst deal in the room. On American roulette, the green pockets already tip the scales. The basket bet takes that tilt and turns it into a landslide. Adding a single green pocket does not just nudge the odds, it transforms the entire game. On European roulette, the house edge is 2.7%. That means, for every $100 placed in bets, the expected long-term loss is $2.70. But on American wheels with both 0 and 00, the edge jumps to 5.26%. That is $5.26 lost per $100 wagered, nearly double the disadvantage with just one extra slot. Pit supervisors know this difference down to the decimal. One recalls that when a player asked why they had two greens, the supervisor said it was the casino's bread and butter, and that the second zero was pure profit. The wheel's symmetry is an illusion, but the math is absolute. Every spin on an American table carries twice the cost, not because of bigger bets or riskier play, but because of a simple change in geometry. The impact is not just theoretical. Over 1,000 spins, a player betting $10 per round will lose about $270 on a single zero wheel, but over $520 on a double zero wheel. That extra zero shaves hours off a bankroll's life. For the casino, it is a guaranteed uptick in revenue, predictable, steady, and invisible to most players. The difference between 2.7% and 5.26% is not just a number on a chart. It is the silent force that makes American roulette the house's favorite version. No betting pattern, no lucky streak. No system can erase the effect of that extra green slot. The math always catches up. Martingale is the most famous system in roulette. The idea is simple. double your bet after every loss, and when you finally win, you recover all losses and pocket a profit equal to your original stake. On paper, it looks like a safety net. In reality, it is a trap that dealers have watched snap shut on players for decades. Consider a player starting with $5 on black. The first spin is a loss, so the next bet is $10. Lose again, and it is $20. Another loss, $40. Then $80. $160. $320. After just 7 losing spins, the next bet would need to be $640, if the table even allows it. Most tables cap bets well before that point. A $5 minimum table often has a $500 or $1,000 maximum. Hitting that cap, the system breaks. The player cannot double again, and all previous losses are exposed at once. Dealers recall regulars who walked in confident, only to find themselves stuck at the table limit after a long streak of reds or blacks. One ex-pit boss remembers a night when a Martingale player's sequence went $5, $10, $20, $40, $80, $160, $320. The ball landed on green, then red, then green again. By the time the player reached the 7th bet, he was staring at the table maximum sign, unable to double further. The next spin, another loss, wiped out over $600 in a single round. The math behind Martingale does not care about patterns or streaks. Each spin is independent. The house edge applies to every bet, no matter how you arrange them. Losing streaks are rare, but over hundreds of spins, they are inevitable. The system's promise of guaranteed recovery is an illusion, one that collapses as soon as the table limit or bankroll runs out. What looks like a clever way to beat the wheel is just another path to losing, engineered by the same math that powers every other bet. Roulette tables once moved at a leisurely pace. Dealers would chat with players, wait for bets, spin the ball, pay out, and clear chips at a comfortable rhythm. 35 to 40 spins an hour was standard. That pace gave players time to think, to savor the game, and without realizing it, to slow the rate at which the house edge chipped away at their bankrolls. Then management started pushing for efficiency. Procedures tightened, distractions were minimized, and dealers learned to keep the wheel moving. A former dealer recalls, "They told us, if you can get to 50 spins an hour, you're doing your job. If you can push it higher, you're a star." The impact is not just about tempo, it is arithmetic. Every spin is a new exposure to the house edge. 2.7% on a European wheel, 5.26% on American. If a player bets $10 per spin, 40 spins an hour means an expected loss of $10.80 on a single zero table. Double the pace to 80 spins, possible on rapid or automated wheels, and the expected loss doubles to $21.60, even though the bet size and edge stay the same. The wheel itself has not changed. The math has not changed. What has changed is the number of times you face that math every hour you sit at the table. Casinos track spins per hour as closely as they track table drop and win rate. The more spins, the more predictable the profit. Dealers are evaluated on how quickly they can clear the felt, call no more bets, and get the ball moving again. High-velocity dealing is not about excitement. It is about volume. Every extra spin is another chance for the house edge to do its work. Players rarely notice the shift. The game feels the same, but the drain on their bankroll accelerates. As one ex-dealer puts it, "You don't have to change the odds to make people lose faster. Just spin the wheel more often." The pace is the quiet multiplier, turning a slow leak into a steady stream. For the casino, it is operational math. For the player, it is a faster countdown to zero. Casino floors run on probability, not superstition. Surveillance rooms are filled with screens and spreadsheets, not hunches. Every roulette wheel has an ID, every spin is logged, and every outcome is tracked. The numbers are tallied by software that does not blink. A former surveillance lead describes how the system works. If a wheel starts to look even a little bit off, we know. We are not watching for lucky streaks. We are watching for math that does not add up. Modern wheels come with built-in diagnostics. Drop zone detection tracks exactly where the ball leaves the track, spin after spin. If the ball starts favoring a particular section, or if a cluster of numbers hits more often than random chance predicts, the system flags it. Surveillance teams do not wait for complaints. They pull up the data, thousands of spins at a time, looking for patterns that cross the line, from noise to signal. A five-number sector hitting 20% more often than expected over 3,000 spins. That is not luck. That is a problem. When the data crosses the threshold, usually a p-value below 0.05, or a sector showing two or three standard deviations above the mean, an investigation begins. The wheel is inspected for levelness, wear, and rotor balance. Sometimes it is just a matter of dust in the track or a worn ball. Other times, a subtle tilt or mechanical flaw is enough to create a real, exploitable bias. If the inspection confirms a problem, the wheel is pulled from the floor immediately. The logbook records the removal, and a replacement wheel is rolled out before the next shift. The process is clinical, almost routine. The reason is simple. Casinos do not want wheels that can be beaten. A biased wheel is a threat to the house, not the player. The law of large numbers is the casino's best friend. They count on thousands of spins to smooth out short-term swings and guarantee their edge. Any deviation, any persistent pattern, is treated as a risk to the bottom line. The house does not need to rig the game. The math is already on their side. Their only job is to make sure the math stays pure. Spin after spin. Every year, casinos earn billions from roulette, almost entirely thanks to the invisible edge built into the wheel. As digital gaming and fast-paced tables spread, that edge touches more lives than ever. The odds have not changed, but who understands them or ignores them still decides the outcome. In the end, the real gamble is not on the wheel. It is on whether you know when to walk away. What would you do?